part three of the simple stormwater drainage network. What we will talk about in this particular video is the design scenario, which will allow the program to actually design your inlets and your manholes and your piping, where I can size it up, size it down, adjust the elevations and stuff like that. So we'll talk about the design scenario, and then we'll talk about some other miscellaneous changes that you can do and look at for your drainage design to make your network maybe function a little bit better. So we'll kind of show you some options with that. And if you watched part two, that video, we noticed that we had an issue with this particular manhole right here where it was a little bit deeper than what it should have been. So if I come over here and I will select view number one and I will select this particular manhole, if I get to my dynamic toolbar, I can go to properties. And right now my elevation for my invert is set to 912. Let's say we adjust that and we'll put in 915. And I'll tap to lock it in. And now you'll notice that it changed right here. Plus it also changed in your 3D window. So you can kind of see that change automatically being reflected. And by design right now, we have it set to where your pipes will go up and down to the bottom of that inlet, whether it's a manhole or an inlet right now. So those pipes will adjust also. So kind of keep that in mind that if you change that, while it may change what you want there, maybe your slopes will not be correct after that and stuff like that. That's just stuff you have to consider whenever you're changing the actual depth of what your inlets are. So if I go back in here and I'm just going to compute it again, and this is something that you will have to do, is if you make changes to your design where you're adjusting your elevations or you're changing your pipe size and stuff like that, you will need to go back in and compute it again. So I will go back to my analyze, and I could go to my compute center, or you can click on this button right here that says compute, since I have that design scenario already set. And it had a convergence was achieved. And if I go back to my profile run and view it now, you see that it looks a little bit better. And there's some stuff that we may need to look at. We have some hydraulic jumps that are in there that we may want to address, or we can change some of the aspects with that. Let me close that down. I will close down my 3D window, and now I will go ahead and expand out my 2D window. So the next thing that we're going to do is actually come in here and do a design scenario. And like I stated in the previous video, I like to do a file save as, because I may have all this set the way I want it, and maybe I just want to do a design scenario where I want to see what the program is going to do and make those inlets of what it thinks it needs to be, so I don't screw up anything that I have set for this file. So I'll just go ahead and save it. I'll do a file save as. Actually, I'll save it first, and I'll do an update server copy. That way I save my changes. And now I'll just do a file save as, and I'll name this one drainage_DS. And that's just being abbreviated for a design scenario. You can name it whatever you want. And I'll check this one in. And now we have open this next file, which is named drainage_DS, which is abbreviation for design scenario. So now if I come back into my compute center, and this time instead of doing the base analysis 25 year for the central district, I will go ahead and do a 25 year base design. Loads up the attributes of what it needs to compute it hydraulically. And now I will go ahead and click on the compute button. Now you will get this right here that says this design calculations may modify the physical properties of it. You want an alternate of it. I'm not going to do that since I did a file save as. So I'll just do no. And basically what it's going to do is look at your design that you had and use the default constraints that you have set up for your design and try to set it and meet those particular design constraints. So we're good to go there. We can go ahead and close it out. And if we go back to our profile run, which we still should have, you'll see that it designed it doing this right here. And if that's what you want, you could use this. Or you may come in here and start to adjust some of these accordingly. So basically it took what design constraints that are set up out there and design it accordingly. And it's using some of these constraints underneath the default design constraints. It's looking at some of this stuff that's set up underneath here in order for it to do the design for like the minimum velocity, the maximum velocity, the cover, the slope. It's looking at all these design constraints and trying to make that drainage network to fit those default design constraints. Now, you may want to change those, which is perfectly fine, but that's basically what the program is doing. And of course, with these other attributes too, for the maximum spread, maximum gutter depth, and stuff like that. So it's using those to do the design. And you can look at this. If you want to use this, then you can use this as your design, or you can go back into your previous file and make changes accordingly. So that's basically what the design scenario does. It just takes what you have, looks at your design constraints, and tries to modify that design to the best of its ability to make that stormwater drainage network work properly. So now I'm going to go back into the previous file, and what we're going to talk about in there is just some simple modifications that we can do to that design to maybe make it fit to what you want. Maybe adjust the bottom elevations of the nodes, maybe add some additional CFS to the piping system or at the inlet for existing water that may be coming into it. Just certain design stuff that you may encounter that would fit into a particular design drainage scenario. So I'll go ahead and open up that previous file. Check this one in. So on our first change here, let's say we have additional water being collected into this node. Let's say that we had this drainage area right here that's being collected, but maybe this parking lot right here, maybe that water is actually being collected into this node also. And it's going to be collected at the surface, not in the piping system. And you'll see that here in a second of what I'm talking about. So if I come in here, if I select this particular node, or it could be any node if there's additional water going into it, and you go to the utility properties, here's all the properties for that particular node and stuff that you could adjust per that particular node. So if we scroll down through here, one option that we can look at is your flows. So let's say you had additional water that's coming into it at the surface level. This is where I would want to come in here and apply that in this spot right here. So if I had an additional 2 cubic feet coming into that inlet at the top, I would add it to this spot right here. And it says additional flow at the inlet of the catch basin. It has a potential to be bypassed by a gutter network because it's actually coming in at the top. So if you had additional flow coming in at the top, this is where you would input that. Now, if you had additional water that's just going into the piping system, let's say you had an existing structure that was out there and you're tying into this new one, then you would come in here and say, I have an additional flow of 2 cubic feet that's just going into the actual system, not coming in down from the top of the node. And you can see that right here where it says used to identify a known pipe flow into the piped system. So this is where you'd come in here if it's just adding it down into the actual piping system, and you could add that additional CFS. And like I said, this would be an example of where you have existing drainage network that's tying into a new one, and you knew the actual CFS that's coming through there, the Q value. This is where you could put that in at the start node, basically, of where the existing is tying into the new and give it that additional flow. So I'll just put in 2 on that one. So that's one example of where you can modify the system. And like I said, anytime you make changes like this, it's not automatically going to reflect. In order for that to show up, you'd have to do a compute and then possibly go back into your profile run to visually see that additional water going into it, or if you've adjusted your elevations. So that's one example. And this could also be added if it's just added to the manhole. if I come into my manhole and I select it and I get to the utility properties of it, I can do the same thing for the manhole. I can come in here and it says flow going into the piping system. I know if there's an additional 5 CFS or 2 CFS or whatever is coming into that system, I can add it right at that spot. And it wouldn't reflect anything that is tied to it before that water gets into it for your new drainage network. So the next thing that we're going to do is change our node elevations. So right now, this one here, I think we set it to 915. So if I go back into my properties, I'm going to look at this. This is at set at 915. Let's say I want to have that set to maybe 913. So I'll lock that one in. And now it's changed. I could look at it in my 3D also just to make sure. Now I know my water is going from here down to here and it's going this way. So I will need to come in here. Since I changed this one, I probably want to come in here and I want to look at this one. So I would do the same thing. Go to the properties of it. It's set at 913.85, so it's above my previous one. So I'm going to have a flooded piping system coming through there. So I would probably want to adjust that a little bit deeper. Let's say we go to 912 on this one. Enter to lock that one in. And now it's changed. Now, anytime that you change stuff in the physical properties of it, it is a very good suggestion to go into the utility properties of it also, because it doesn't always reflect if you change it in one and it reflects in the other. There's a lot of disconnects with this, so I would definitely want to go back in here. If I change it in one, I'd probably want to go back and change it and look at the other, for if it's the physical properties or if it's the hydraulic properties. So just to double check that, I change this one to 913. I will go back into the utility properties and just double check that. And it did change, so that's good. So I'll go back to my other one and review it, and it did update accordingly there. So that's good. Not always will it do that. So just like I said, double check those. If you change one, go ahead and change and look at the other to make sure they're the same. Now with our pipes, the way we have it set by default is if you adjust your elevation, your invert elevation of your particular node, the pipe is going to go down to that bottom elevation. Just to kind of show that, right now I have this one here selected. If I go to one of my conduits that's tying into it, and if you look through here, we have these options where it says physical to set invert to start and set invert to stop. By default, we have it set to true. And what it will do there is if it's set to true, it's going to set the start and the stop inverts of that pipe to be with that particular elevation of the node. So kind of keep that in mind. If you don't want that, you can set that to false, and then you could actually adjust where your pipe is tying in to that particular node. If it needs to be higher than the actual bottom elevation, this is where you would set that to false, and you could set it to whatever elevation of where you think it needs to be, which is not a typical situation, but that is an option. Another thing that you can look at inside of your conduit properties is if you want to design. Right now, we have all of our set to design conduit set to true. So whenever it does a design scenario, if the size pipe is too small, it'll actually go through there and make it bigger or smaller, depending on what the situation is. If for some reason you want that set to a certain pipe and that's what you want for sure, you could change that to false. And if you were to do a design scenario, it wouldn't do anything with that pipe. It would stay whatever size that you put it. And you can look at some of these other options through here. Is culvert, if it is a culvert, of course you set that to true. That's not the case for this instance here, so we would leave that set to false because it does the calculations differently if it's a stormwater drainage network like what we have or if it's a culvert situation. Another thing that you can look at is your node reversal. Let's say you drew this in from this manhole right here and you drew it going up to this node, but the water is actually going from this node going down. This is where you can come in here and actually reverse that and say, my start node is one and my stop node is the other, versus redrawing that particular conduit. So that's what the reversal will allow you to do. Another thing that I'm going to show is, like I said, and I mentioned this before, but just make sure that if you change your size of your pipe, make sure you look at both the physical properties and the hydraulic properties, like what we're looking like right now. Because if you come in here and change your properties from like a 12 inch to a 15 inch, and you see that it changed to a 15 inch. If we go back in and double check our utility properties, it did change, so that's good. Like I said, sometimes that does not change like the way it should, so just kind of keep that in mind to make sure that they're linked together. So those are just a few examples of where you can change your stuff. I'm not going to go over every option that's in there, but hopefully you have the idea of the stuff that you can change and stuff that you can look for and get it to where you can modify your drainage network to what you need for your particular situation. Now, we did make some changes to this. Remember, we add the extra CFS to this pipe. We made this pipe a little bit bigger, and also we adjusted these elevations. Now, that's not going to reflect in my profile run until I do a compute again. And just to kind of verify that, if I go to my open analysis profile, and now you'll notice that it did adjust some of your elevations of your manholes that you did and possibly sized up and down some of your pipes, but it still doesn't add that extra CFS in the piping system. So it's always a good idea, if you ever make any changes to your design, make sure you do a compute and then go back to your profile run to see your new scenario. So if I come back in here and I close this out, and just to kind of verify that, I will go ahead and select this particular node, and I have an extra 2 CFS. I'm just going to make that a little bit bigger. I'm just going to do 10 CFS. And you notice that the change has been made. If I go back into my profile run to view it, you'll still see it was exactly the same as what it previously was. So it doesn't add that extra water that's coming actually into the piping system for this example. So make sure you do a compute. Close it out. And now if I go back into my Explorer, we should see some nodes that are probably flooded, which they are because we have that additional water going through it. So like I said, I just wanted to show you that so you can make sure your profile run reflects to the current design that you currently have. So kind of keep that in mind. So that's the design scenario where you can actually do a design. Like I said, I would suggest just doing a file save as and doing a design scenario, and then you can look at what it adjusted and you can change that accordingly, and you can use that as your design for your drainage, or you can go back to your previous one and adjust it accordingly. And then we showed you some modifications that you can do to your network to get it to the way you want for your particular situation that you have. Hopefully this helps out. And if you got any questions about drainage, feel free to call CAD support and we will help you out.